I suggest you study this.
The views and opinions expressed on the Faygoluvers Podcast do not necessarily reflect those of us here at Faygoluvers.net. Some episodes may contain disturbing content. Discretion is advised. What's up, ninjas, and welcome to episode number 11 of the Faygoluvers Podcast. Today is January 22nd. I'm your homie Roscoe, and I'm going to be your host for this episode of the podcast. Holy shit, ninjas, there has been a lot of bullshit, a lot of controversy going down recently in the Juggalo world, especially in the past 2 weeks. Faygoluvers recently posted an interview with the Insane Clown Posse, and it was a tell-all interview about what's been going on with them in Magic Ninja Entertainment for the most part over the past couple years. That's been really the hit thing going on with Faygoluvers.net right now. We're going to definitely talk about that a little bit later on, but for now, I just want to mention that we have our homie Marz on this episode of the podcast, and what an appropriate time to have an OG Lotus member coming on the podcast. I gotta say though, this interview was actually conducted before all of this this controversy was going on within the Juggalo world, so he's not really gonna speak on that at all, mostly because it hadn't happened yet, and even if it had happened, I'm not sure he would have anything to say on it, but definitely listen for that interview because shit is dope. Also, I want to bring up that on this episode of the Faygoluvers Podcast, we have that ninjette, Nikki Wickked, the newest news ninja to Faygoluvers.net, and we talk about ICP, we talk about the underground, we talk about Faygoluvers Heaven, and it's a dope interview. Definitely stick around and listen for that. Alright ninjas, let's just get this out of the way right now. I don't want to talk about this in our news segment, I want to just talk about it right now, we'll just get it out of the way. Recently, Faygoluvers Heaven conducted an interview, our homie Scotty D conducted an interview with the Insane Clown Posse. It was a tell-all interview. A lot of the interview was Violent J speaking on Twisted, Magic Ninja Entertainment, and Young Wicked. And although I can't play the entire interview here on the podcast, I'm just going to try and sum it up as best I can, because there's no real sound bites that I really want to pull, so here we go. I'm going to try and sum it up as best I can. Forgive me if I fuck this up. Violent J and Shaggy 2 Dope were cool with Twisted when they left, okay? They wanted Twisted to continue playing Juggalo events and like the Dark Lotus album and all that shit. Twisted was demanding things like masters and stuff like that from ICP in order to play these events. So they would demand that Psychopathic give them albums, which Violent J said, record labels do not do that, but the Hatchet was cool enough to do that for Twisted. Now that they're playing the merch, Twisted and Magic Ninja Entertainment are refusing to play the merch, but they are still willing to headline Juggalo Day. Violent J seems to have a problem with this, as well as a lot of Juggalos seem to have a problem with this. On top of that, all this bullshit going down with Young Wicked right now, him jumping ship and signing with Magic Ninja Entertainment, and Violent J made it very clear that he let George and Magic Ninja Entertainment know that they were not okay with that going down, but they went ahead and did it anyways. Also, Twisted and Magic Ninja Entertainment got kicked off of Juggalo Day, and they will not be invited to the gathering. ICP is going to cut all ties with them ninjas. I think I summed it up. I probably missed a whole bunch of shit. But that was it for the most part. Now, because Twisted did release a response, and it was a short response. It wasn't a two-hour-long thing like we had with Faygoluvers here. I'm going to play that for you ninjas right now. Here is Twisted responding to the Insane Clown Posse interview that Faygoluvers Heaven conducted. Here we go.
Let's start at the top. We want to apologize first and foremost to everybody who had plans on seeing Dark Lotus.
To everybody.
I mean, well, yeah, no.
Be involved with or just have to hear any of this. This is ridiculous.
100%.
But look, as
Don't
far as
that.
Juggalo Day, we were uninvited.
Mm-hmm.
You know, there ain't shit we could do about
right.
that. We tried to do. We got, you know, 75% of Lotus here, and we're like, we're down.
Do or do not do the show. But stop with all the goddamn bullshit.
Don't blame
it's
it
just
on
stupid.
Otis.
Don't
we got
blame it on
text
him.
Message of y'all telling us, go ahead, sign Otis. There's no beef. It's all good.
I don't understand why he can't respect the fact that we don't want to participate in his march. That's, I feel, what perpetuated and got us all here to begin with in the beginning.
Yeah, I believe that has a part of it. They just don't understand our creative difference, and instead of having to throw them dudes under the bus,
No. We're not going to do what everybody thinks we're going to do and start slinging shit. It's not even about that. My best comment to you guys is to stop, because damn,
there's two sides to every story.
That fair enough.
But
okay,
to the ones that have unequivocally just had our backs, and they get it, and to know Twisted is to know our decisions and
no,
how we
100%,
do what we do.
100%.
Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you, guys. Thank you, guys, for standing by us. Thank you, guys, for not picking a side, because never once did we ever say for anyone to pick a side.
You don't know all the text messages and the phone calls and the
God damn it, I'm getting hot.
And just
oh,
it comes down to
yeah,
that is that we will not be strong-armed or bullied or made to do anything.
Right. So
by anybody. We left Psychopathic to get away from ICP and their wrongdoings of us. Don't y'all get that? And y'all see, in the beginning, some were mad. As time passed, you get it now. And I'm telling you, you'll get it again. You'll see.
I'm not trying to belittle someone for their beliefs.
No.
To me, that's not what a Juggalo is about. A Juggalo is about embracing your individuality. And if I'm to be told what to do, there's no individuality in that. That's a Rictatorship.
Right.
Is that a real word?
And it ain't about me. And it ain't about him. It's about you. And I don't want you to have to look at your fucking tattoos any differently. So know what you're marching for.
Know what you're marching for.
Marching for publicity for another band. That's it.
You know what? Just stop. Just please stop. And just stop. I'm just saying to all the real Juggalos out there, we got nothing but Juggalo love.
Come on.
If you want to march, march.
Right,
if you don't,
right.
Don't.
So there you go, ninjas. Twisted's response. What do y'all think of that? But in that interview, it wasn't all just talk of Twisted, Magic Ninja, and Young Wicked. There was also some very important news items dropped in the interview. And I'm not going to fill you in. I'm going to let the interview speak for itself. Here's Violent J talking about the upcoming fourth Joker's card of the second deck. Check it out.
Last year, you and I talked about this a little bit on our interview at the your solo tour in Phoenix, right? You mentioned that the image for the fourth Joker's card of the second deck has come to you. When are you prepared to reveal it?
Not for a long time.
Okay.
Yeah, I know way more about it now.
Okay.
Crazy more about it. Like, I can't even believe I said that then, because I knew so little. I probably shouldn't have said that.
Okay.
Because I did know it, but I didn't know anything about it. Mm-hmm. But now I know it thoroughly. It's crazy fresh. In our minds, crazy fresh.
But we're talking about probably at least another year before we see anything.
No, 2018.
For you ninjas that are worried that the Juggalo March is going to double as the Juggalo Gathering, have no fear. Check out this sound clip right now.
I know it's been squashed in the past, but a lot of Juggalos wrote in and asked, will this still double as the official gathering?
No,
absolutely not.
No,
okay.
Not at all, man. I think we almost got a place locked down in Colorado.
Let's hope so, right?
It might be a smaller place. You might have to, you know, people. It might not be as big as
we're gonna get.
We're gonna get what we can get. You know what I'm saying? And plus, you know, it might be time for a smaller place. You know what I'm saying? It's a lot going on in our world. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So there you go, ninjas. That's all I'm really gonna say on the whole ICP Twisted thing going on right now. Got it out of the way right at the start of the episode. So hurrah! We're gonna get into the news. Check it out. Is there anything specifically you don't want me to ask about?
No, you could ask anything, bro. Like, you could ask, like, the most worst question that you think I wouldn't want to answer.
Well, I like to beat the law, and I piss a lot of people off. This middle finger on my hand so I don't give a damn if you like it or not. I ain't high class, a bike bum, dive bar bikes and guns, and I run with the wild one. With the wild one. Yeah, with the wild one.
Texas and they sent me to jail. Did a night in the can, wrote the song for myself. Running on empty, full tank of whiskey. Old lady love me, but the kids still miss me. Blue lights, flashing sirens and whistles. Mugshot, whiskey, bar stools and pistols. Bikers to clampers, buck to haggard. I'm running with the wild ones, drink till we stagger.
They're always trying to make me conform to diminishing. And day by day they try to take away more of my liberty. Why stay free, open road, live for the ride with a rebel soul, and I know my name will live even when I
go. Welcome. Blue Wizard is about to die. Green Elf needs food badly.
If you are a Juggalo and you are a gamer, then this is definitely the convention for you. Of course, I am talking about the Dark Carnival Games Convention going down in April, April 21st, 22nd, and 23rd at the Gibraltar Trade Center in Mount Clemens, Michigan. The website has launched. The official website has dropped. You can find that at dcgcon.com. Link for that is in the description of this podcast. All of the information that you need on the convention can be found at that website, and I totally recommend downloading the official program. A 3-day badge to get into all 3 days of this bomb-ass gaming event is only $40, ninjas. Hells yes. And let me tell you what comes along with that 3-day badge. With the 3-day badge, you also get a ticket to the after parties, which will feature concerts from the entire Psychopathic Records roster. Hell yeah. And like I said, the only way to get in is to order a 3-day DCG badge. And once you get your badge, you should be receiving a pass for those after parties as well, until they run out anyways. Autographs are going down. The first day, you can get your shit signed from all of the game designers of your favorite Dark Carnival games. The second day, you can get your autograph signed from the entire Psychopathic Records roster. I'm talking about ICP, ABK, DJ Clay, Big Hoodoo, Blase Rose, and Light. Also, merchandise. Hells yes. There's going to be all kinds of Dark Carnival Game Con merchandise available, everything from t-shirts and hats. You also get Into the Echocide, the new Juggalos Against Sanity game, and check this out, ninjas, Morton's List. That's right. The only place you're going to be able to buy Morton's List brand new is this convention. It will not be available on any websites. It will not be available at any retailers. If you want to pick that shit up brand new, hit up this convention. Also, like I mentioned on the post, BattleTech Center. Shit, yeah. Hit up DCGCon and get your game on, ninja. Those ninjas over at the Underground Australia have announced the winner for the 2016 Underground Album of the Year. Check it out. Coming in at number 10 was Vinnie Paz's The Cornerstone of the Corner Store. Number 9 was Kung Fu Vampires Look Alive. Number 8 was Big Hoodoo's Asylum. Number 7 was Des Luca's SKX. Number 6 was Jimmy Don's Anxiety Music. Number 5 was Ritz's Top of the Line. Number 4 was Lex the Hexmaster's Contact. Number 3 was Tech Nine's The Storm. Number 2 was G-Mosky's My Filthy Spirit Bomb. And coming in at number 1 and winner of Underground Album of the Year is Blaze Ya Dead Homie's The Casket Factory. Hells yes, congrats Dead Homie. Here is a clip of Ned from the Underground letting Blaze know that his album Casket Factory won Underground Album of the Year. Check it out.
One. And coming in at number one, being dead hasn't stopped this man. It is the one, the only, Blaze Ya Dead Homie with the Casket Factory. Blaze, congratulations, sure, man. Sure.
Hell yeah, thank y'all, man. I gotta say thank y'all to everybody out there, man. I'll tell you before, I'm blessed, man. I got blessed to have everybody out there believing in it and picking up the record, and most importantly, voting and, you know, just supporting and rocking with me. You know what I mean?
Yeah, definitely, man. And I want to ask just straight up, how much do you think it helped your chances of winning this album of the year by threatening to put your fans' asses in a box, Blaze?
I mean, you know, it was just part of the fun. You listen to the record, you know where I'm at.
No, in all seriousness, though, man, it's a solid album and deserving winner. How was the recording process of The Casket Factory? Because I guess now, man, you would have recorded most of this back in 2015.
Oh, yeah, man. We recorded it well earlier, and we were just putting it together and, you know, just putting together a sweet plan for when we put it out. So, yeah, we did probably get it together maybe 5 months before, and that's kind of how you do stuff nowadays, try to get everything situated so you're ready for when you're actually dropping the record, you know?
Yeah, most definitely, man. Well, 2016 was a very extremely busy year for you, man. You dropped the Casket Maker EP, the Dead Vultures EP, Zodiac Imprint as well. Damn, you don't stop, Dead Man.
Yeah, sir. You know, I'm still working, man. I got more stuff. I was just out in the studio yesterday. I'm dropping a couple features on a couple of people's records. And, you know, it's like just trying to keep busy. I got some more projects I've been working on that's going to be coming up soon. You'll hear about, you know, within probably next couple months. You know, just working on some new stuff. Hopefully dropping another record maybe close to the end of this year is what I'm looking forward to. And if it's not me, it's going to be a project that I'm going to be involved in. One way or another, I'm dropping something.
Tech N9ne has announced a brand new tour that's going to be going down in 2017 titled the Strictly Strange Tour. And that shit is going to feature the likes of Tech N9ne, Chris Calico, Stevie Stone, Seth Crew, and that ninja, Brother Lynch Hung. Hell yeah. It's going to be 68 shows in 74 days. VIP packages are available at strangevip.com. You can check out the link for that in the show notes. The tour is starting out in Omaha, Nebraska on March 22nd and going to be ending off in Wichita, Kansas on June 22nd. All the dates for the tour have been announced. Hit up the link in the show notes to check those out, and I will see you ninjas there. How they grungy when they all take it in the hip.
So you fell and busted your ass face first. The longer you're down there, the longer shit is passing you by. Get the fuck up. Get with it. Dust your fucking ass off and get with the program.
Psychopathic Records has released their 2017 Year of the Juggalo infomercial. That shit was supposed to drop on January 1st. It took them a little bit longer than anticipated, but it did finally drop, ninjas. And the infomercial is basically just the entire Psychopathic Records roster, just putting out some freshness, just putting out some positivity. Hit up the link in the show notes if you want to see that. But also, this episode of the podcast is going to have sound clips of that peppered throughout it. So you'll probably be hearing a lot of that infomercial just by listening to this podcast. But like I said, hit up the link in the show notes to check it out. Also on the infomercial, they did announce that there's going to be another infomercial for the Juggalo March dropping very soon, so definitely keep your ears and eyes peeled for more information on that, ninja.
In 2011, Juggalos were officially declared a gang by the United States Federal Bureau of Investigations. It was the first time in U.S. history that the federal government essentially criminalized a specific type of musical culture. More than censorship, the precedent was set that identifying as a juggalo was in fact illegal. The repercussions of this blatant act of discrimination by our nation's government against devoted music followers has not only damaged thousands of innocent lives, but turned disastrous for the image of juggalos everywhere. Along with help from the Michigan American Civil Liberties Union, ICP attempted to sue the FBI. However, the case has now been thrown out of court 3 times, having never gone to trial. And so with no choice left, on the weekend of September 15th, 2017, the Juggalos will come together and collectively march on Washington, D.C., united as a family. Their only goal is to say to the rest of the country, as loudly and proudly as possible,
we ain't having that, bitch! Woo woo!
So our homie Marz was the first one to hit up Scotty about this. And I'm talking about Marz with an S, not the Marz that we have on this episode of the podcast. But unfortunately, those ninjas in Potluck, Underrated and One Ton, are no longer together. Underrated posted a Facebook status letting ninjas know that after 15 plus years, the group has disbanded. There was not really any reason given as to why, but he still says that he's looking forward to the future, so that's a good thing. Yeah, I really don't have much to say on this, ninjas, except that like Scotty says in the post, It was an honor being a fan of Potluck throughout the years, and should they never perform again or make another album, their shit is still dope, and they'll always be remembered. So much love, Potluck. Him,
but I'm not bitter, not mean, just take respect when I'm riding on a beat, rap mix, I produce, I can do all three, I'm a beast in the studio, killing MCs.
If y'all ninjas need some proof that 2017 is going to be the year of Diamond Rain, check this shit out. The Insane Clown Posse has been invited to play Rockfest in Wisconsin in July. Hells yeah, ninjas. I'm talking about the Wicked Clowns are going to be playing the same stages as Avenged Sevenfold, Rob Zombie, Korn, Slayer, Shinedown, Megadeth, Stone Sour, Lamb of God, Clutch, Anthrax. The list goes on and on and on. This is some dope shit, ninjas. The cheapest price that Scotty was able to find for the three-day event is $220, and you can actually check out the link in the show notes to order your tickets, or hit up rock-fest.com for more information.
From the dark side of the nighttime, I'll be creeping. Nocturnal child of the night, daytime, come on, I'm sleeping. In the 6 feet deep, holding the earth, literally speaking. I'm underground with a glowing eye, that of a demon, believing the soul is not here for the eating.
All right, ninjas, check it out. This is an example of an atom bomb that's about to be dropped on the Faygoluvers podcast. And I might just find like a sound effect of a bomb dropping, and I'll just play that before the news item from now on. That way you ninjas know the news is about to be devastating. Check it out. On the most recent episode of Twisted's podcast, Ashtrays and Action Figures, they basically announced the entire list of albums that they had planned out for 2017, Magic Ninja's Year of the Sword. And we're going to go through that list right now. I was actually going to play the sound clip from Ashtrays and Action Figures, but it's a little bit long, and I feel like I can maybe go through it a little bit quicker, so check it out. So starting in January 27th, is Twisted's The Continuous Evolution of Life's Question Marks. It's dropping in about 5 days. The Gorilla Voltage album is dropping in February. No title for that yet. I'm thinking it may just be a self-titled album. We'll have to wait and see. Boondocks' new album, The Murder, is dropping in March. The ROC's album Digital Voodoo is finally dropping in April, after years and years of hearing about it. A 7-inch vinyl is going to be dropping on a Record Store Day. Lex the Hexmaster's new album is titled Beyond Redemption, and the release date for that is yet to be determined. Young Wicked's new album, The Return of the Prodigal Son, which we talked about on the last episode of the podcast, is to be determined. The Axe Murder Boys have an album, dropping on Magic Ninja Entertainment. No release date for that, no title for that, but I'm wondering if it's going to be that Muerte album that was advertised in Young Wicked's release Slaughter. Gonna have to wait and see. Twisted is releasing a vinyl picture disc for their album Abominations. G-Mosky's Charlie and the Filth Factory is coming out. There's going to be a Magic Ninja collaboration album dropping, which is going to be dope. A full-length Zodiac imprint album is going to be dropping. And we talked about this a couple episodes ago on the podcast, a Triple Threat album, a full-length Triple Threat album is going to be dropping. And for you ninjas that don't know, Triple Threat is the team of Twisted and Blaze. Check that shit out, ninjas. Definitely stay tuned to Faygoluvers.net because we're going to have all of that information coming to you as we get it. For all my ninjas who watch Orange is the New Black, some of y'all are probably familiar with this actress Taylor Schilling. She played Piper on that show. She's going to be starring in an indie film titled Family. Hells yeah. Not too much has been released about the film as of yet, but we do know that it is about Taylor and her 13-year-old niece who desperately wants to become a Juggalo. This was reported on by Yahoo and The Hollywood Reporter. Faygoluvers actually has a little bit more details about this, but we're not going to reveal it as of yet. Keep your eyes and ears peeled for more on this new indie film, Family, that's going to be dropping very soon. So this is going to be the last piece of news that I'm dropping on this episode of the Faygoluvers podcast, but it is dope. Check this out, ninjas. Did ICP and Twisted just appear in an episode of The Simpsons? This past Sunday, January 15th, an episode of The Simpsons aired titled The Great Fatsby, and although I personally did not watch the episode, I do know that there was a scene that took place in Milhouse's room, and on his wall is a lot of rap posters, including a family tree of horrorcore. Now, if you zoom in and check out that Family Tree of Horrorcore poster, on the very far right at the bottom is a picture of what appears to be Twisted, and directly beside them on the left is what appears to be a picture of ICP during their Shangri-La era. A lot of ninjas, I mean, it has to be Twisted. Like, it has to be. There's no other artist it could be. Some ninjas don't think it's a picture of ICP, mostly because their makeup is more colorful, almost like they're from the Shangri-La era. But I don't know who else it could be. These ninjas that are straight out of DK actually posted a picture of the tree with who they think every single artist on the Family Tree of Horrorcore is. So that shit is dope. Check out the link in the description of this podcast to see that. And I just want to say much love goes out to Matt Groening and The Simpsons for even showing like the littlest amount of love. Much love, ninjas. All right, homies. We're going to get into our short interview that we did with that ninjette Nikki Wickked. After that, we got some commercials, and then we're going to be jumping into our interview that we did with OG Lotus member Marz. Stick around. Welcome back. So I'm here with Nikki Wickked, one of the newest news ninjas, I like to call him, to Faygoluvers Heaven. Nikki, how the hell are you doing?
I'm doing fucking awesome. How are you?
I'm doing all right. Kind of a busy night, busy day. A lot of shit going on in the Juggalo world right now.
I know. It's super busy. It's just crazy. There's so much coming at us, and we're just trying to get it all out there. You know what I mean?
Right. And I kind of want to get your thoughts on that. But before that, I just want to ask, how did you get involved with Faygoluvers Heaven?
You know, before Faygoluvers, I had a little bit of a music hustle going on just through, like, booking and managing and promoting, you know, so I had a little bit of a hustle already going on, and I was just kind of, like, at a weird standstill in evolution, you know, and I was sitting there one night just thinking, and you guys were, like, posting, so I was like, screw it, you know, I'll just reach out to Scotty and see if they need any help, you know, and he was, like, really cool about it. He's like, yeah, he let me jump right in, and it's like turned out to be something that I like really like to do. So,
Shit! Well, there must have been something, because we've had other ninjas, I think, offer to help out with Faygoluvers, and not everybody gets the okay. So there must have been something about Nikki Wickked that made somebody say yes.
Well, I mean, like I said, I've had a little bit of a music hustle. I've got a little bit of a following, you know. So I don't know. I guess he must have liked my hustle and coming together really good.
So we got a Marz interview coming up. So what are your views on Marz?
I think it's super dope. You know, anybody in the music game that's doing, you know, anything and, you know, getting their message out there and, like, helping people is super dope to me. You know, I think he's totally fucking awesome. And, yeah, I can't wait to, you know, listen. I haven't listened to it, but, I need to push that and get that out there. Any type of music, you know what I'm saying, especially if it's in rap form, is super dope to me. So, yeah, like, salute and, yeah. Totally with that.
And that ninja definitely has a positive message to get out there when you hear the interview. And he also has a lot to say, actually, about his days in Dark Lotus and Violent J, too.
I'm interested. I'm totally interested to hear that, you know, especially with everything that's going on, you know, kind of to get the other outsiders' opinions and how they feel and, you know, like what's going on in their head, you know, that's cool. Everyone feels differently and it affects them in different ways, you know, so I don't know. I think it's cool to kind of get everyone's opinion on it and...
Right, so what's your opinion on all the bullshit that's going down right now?
I need all the music in the underground, you know? Like, I pretty much support every type of music that helps me through any part of my life. And you know, that includes both ICP and Twisted. So, you know, I'm going to remain totally neutral on it. You know, I don't really have much to say about it. It's sad to see a lot of my friends, like, you know, hurt and stuff. But I just hope that in the end it'll all sort out and we're going to come back strong. You know, I just vision, like, the day that we all, like, squash beef and we're even stronger, you know what I'm saying? So I'm just going to, like, you know, keep pushing my positive message and, you know, kind of try to keep people's minds off it while it sorts out, you know what I'm saying? I just try to keep other things moving and, you know, just try to keep the fan happy, you know what I'm saying?
Right, right. Yeah, that's an awesome way to look at it, too. I mean, I'm thinking, like, even if it doesn't work out between ICP and Twisted, I'm thinking that the Juggalo world is going to repair itself here in probably, like, the next 6 or 7 months anyway, before the March, in my opinion.
That's crazy. I, like, get goosebumps as you say that. You know what I'm saying? Like, I got total faith. You know what I mean? Like, whatever happens is going to happen. Either way, you know, we have two huge companies that are both, like, recreating themselves, you know? And I think it's beautiful to watch, you know, their strength build. You know, nobody really expected this or whatever, but, you know, you got to go through shit to get through shit, you know? So they're going to come back strong. They always have, you know, they always will, you know, revitalize, rejuvenate, and come back. You know what I'm saying?
Hells yeah. Rise like the phoenix, right?
Fuck yeah. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
But anyways, Nikki, so how did you first get involved with the whole underground music scene?
Well, you know, back in the day when I was super little, I'm like 13, I'm 27 now, I lived in a small area and there really wasn't shit to do. You know, I was kind of a pissed off kid. And so I just started picking up, like, you know, ICP and all underground music. You know, my life, it like grew in phases of music. You know what I'm saying? Like one minute I was totally into this and the next minute I was totally into this. You know, it's like just whatever I was going through at that point in my life, I would embrace. You know, different forms of underground music, and now it's grown to where I know, you know, I know a lot about, you know, each of it. Not everything about all of it, but, you know, a little bit about each of it. I would say when I was like 13, you know, kind of like looking for a fam, because mine was all, you know, broken up and shit. So, yeah, it's been about since I was 13. Like I said, I'm 27.
What band did that start with?
ICP.
Hells yeah. I don't think I know anybody.
Actually, like, it was the only way for me to get, like, my sisters to laugh, you know? Like, when we were, like, all bummed out about our parents' beefing and shit, I would, like, just blare ICP, and we would just wild out, you know what I'm saying? So, it's important. It's close to me in my heart, you know what I'm saying? It stems really far back, and I don't know. It was just a big thing for me and my sisters, so it's sacred to me, you know?
Hells yeah. And then, you know, of course we got like Faygoluvers dedicated to that whole shit.
Yeah, well, it just, you know, it flows so natural and everything happens so quick and, it, you know, it comes to me. I'm not much of a writer, you know what I'm saying? Apparently I'm a little bit good at it, but it flows so natural that it just seems right. It fits right and I feel really good about it, you know.
Hells
I'm like
yeah.
super, super like proud and like honored that this is my team, like. Through all the beef and shit, I'm like, whatever, Faygoluvers.
Hells yeah. And we were just talking about that the other day, actually. Me and Scotty and Shifty saying that it's almost like a therapy, right? Faygoluvers. People whose minds are like a million miles a minute, Faygoluvers is the perfect therapy for that.
It is. You know, it's like a good way for me to kind of get my mind off of stuff. With like, even in my everyday life, you know what I'm saying? Not even in the music world. It is. It's a total therapeutic session. I just love it.
And Nikki, anything, any final words before we take off here?
I just want to shout out all my Twitter followers and all my other followers and the fam, Scotty D, everybody else at Faygoluvers, and much more fucking Nikki Wickked love.
Hells yeah. Thanks for joining us, Nikki.
Yeah. Everybody doing this shit. Everybody doing this style. Claiming they coming to serve us, but they can't even take what they dish out. So I'm dissing dummies till I dismount. Murdering them with the routine. Both eyes break light red. Hot hair full of blue dream. Flip script to a new scene. Crown fit for a true king. Cosigns don't mean shit, but your friends change like a mood ring. Make deals with a firm shake. Now the hand round me too clean. And if y'all don't be dealing with contracts, I don't know what the fuck y'all mean. I've been at it for a minute, meaning I'm really.
I bet you can't say this. Zoe, Zap, Xander, Zucchini. Zombie-like zookeepers make a zillion dollars off of ZD. Zoinks, their Zika in my zigzag. Zapatista zoomed in on Zeus's zygotes. It's just sad. Zelda, zip up your zebra-colored zipper. Zombie zero in on Zebulon, Zany, Zither. Zebras and Zambonis make zilch from Zulu and Zurich. I play in Zydeco and in a Zuzu. Zen, Buddha, Zealots take Zantac on Zeppelins. You get zero Zoloft if your Zachary no questions. Order with Zuda, getting Z's with the Zoftix. There's nothing rhymes with that. Chipotle is awesome. The Zodiac killer one's Lottie's for a Zizipus. Zuckerberg wore a Zoot suit with the Zitabus. Zlanders watch Zoolander out in Zaire. Zed's dead, baby, not in Zanzibar, but right here. Zippity doodah, I love zinc. I kiss Zsa Zsa Gabor, and I rock Z. She unzipped her Z, Cavaricci, and we zazzled. Play the words emergy if you wanna win at Scrabble. Zon Jip is on Zolpidum. It's World War Z, it's too cold for him. Damn, I'm absurd. I think I just ran out of words. Z! That was hard.
Without question, the number 17 is synonymous with the Juggalo world. Some even view the number as a sacred code, that somehow links them directly to the Dark Carnival. There are many theories that attempt to explain why this number is so significant. But the one thing that is definitely unanimous among juggalos everywhere is that the number 17 is special. It is commonly believed to bring luck, fortune, good times, and most of all, karmic shine to juggalos far and wide.
The only true rebels left in this world are the ones that rebel against the system and the spirit of this world. Hey, yo!
Welcome back to the Faygoluvers Podcast, and I am here with OG Lotus member, as many of you juggalos might know him, Marz. How you doing, Marz?
I'm doing great. How you doing, my brother?
I'm doing pretty good, homie. I want to thank you so much for coming on and talking to me on Faygoluvers.net.
My pleasure, man. Thank you for having me.
So to start, the Juggalo world has not heard too much of Marz in the past 10 to 12 years. So can you kind of just fill us in on what you've been up to?
Wow. Has it been that long?
I think That's crazy, man. I think it has, yeah.
Yeah, time flies, you know. What has happened? I mean, a lot. You know, my life completely changed about 6 years ago. You know, I've been doing music since I was a kid. You know, like the short version of the story would be, I was always doing music. I get a record deal. I end up touring with ICP. Jay ends up asking me to be on Dark Lotus. At the time, I was heavily into witchcraft and a lot of crazy things in my life. Ended up doing that. That kind of went sour. Then I got signed to Korn, to their record label. Did a stadium tour with Korn. It was the Pop Sucks tour. I wanted to do my own thing, you know. So then I started my own record label. It was called Billion Dollar Ballers. We were touring with Tech and Paul Wall and just kind of grinding, you know, doing our thing. And in the midst of that, the life change for me was I got saved. And I don't know if you know what that means, but, you know, I was born, my father's Muslim, my mother's Catholic. I was into all type of things, you know. I was into all type of spirituality and witchcraft and just everything, just kind of looking to see, is there more to life than just this? Like, is there more to life than just chasing money and women and power, than smoking weed and drinking? You know, so I was always kind of drawn to that. And so at one point, you know, to make the story short, at one point in my life, I was going through such crazy things. If I actually told you the stories, you probably wouldn't believe me unless you've experienced the demonic before, but it's real. Like, believe that. It's real. Those energies, those entities are real. And through a series of events, I got saved. And what that means is I give my life to Jesus. I accepted Jesus as my savior. And bro, everything changed. Like, my purpose for existence changed, you know. But the funny part of that is when I accepted Jesus, it was at this little ghetto church, and we were actually rehearsing to go on tour with Tech and Paul Wall. So I accepted Jesus. I didn't actually really even know what that meant. I just kind of accepted God. Like, I had been trying to do everything by my own will, my own life. And most of the times when we try to do that, everything goes wrong eventually, because our will is selfish and filled with pride and arrogance and lust. And you know what I mean? So I finally kind of came to the end of myself and I gave my life to God. So the next day when we were rehearsing and that whole tour with Tech and Paul Wall, I was having this struggle in me. It was like hearing my lyrics for the first time, hearing the things that I'm saying for the first time. And I would look at the crowd, you know, and there's hundreds to thousands of kids out there. And I felt like, for the first time I saw, like, I'm just filling you with poison. Do you dig what I'm saying? And so when we got off that tour, man, I had a struggle in me. I'm like, man, I'm going to just give up music. You know, because everything looked different.
Right.
I know now what that is. You know, it's the Holy Spirit. It's a battle, you know, raging inside of you of which way to go. You know, and I decided after that tour, you know, after that tour, I had went to visit some family in Croatia. That's where my mom's from, right next to Italy, for those that don't know. And we live in a little village, you know, and that's where I'm originally from, where I was born. And I just walked through the mountains and the hills. And I had a Bible that a stripper had gave me. And I just read. Bro, yeah, and it's crazy, bro. And by the way, whoever's listening to this, God loves strippers. God loves gangbangers. God loves juggalos. He is a God of love, and he wants us back. And as soon as we want to come back, he's waiting there with open arms. you know, to accept us and to heal us and to strengthen us and then to build us up into who we originally were meant to be according to his plan. And then he sends you back out to get more people. You follow me? So that was a huge life change for me. So I had stopped doing music. I actually went to a Christian rap concert, and it was so horrible. It was so corny, man. And I was like, I was sitting there, and I listened to like five or six different artists, and I was hoping, like, nah, one is going to come up, and he's going to be amazing. And it was just so, just not, you know, what I wanted to do. So afterwards, you know, I prayed, and I was like, Lord, please, please don't ask me to do Christian rap music. It's so lame. you know what I mean?
Right.
And I decided to put music to the side for a minute. I got a job as a security guard in a high-rise downtown, which is crazy, bro, because I'm all tatted up. And then I was in a suit in a high-rise. Like, it was a trip. And people would walk in and recognize me.
Oh, like, dope.
Yeah, you know, like, so people would walk in, you know, and they'd be like, hold on, ain't you Marz? And I'm like, ah, bro, leave me alone, you know?
Right.
But so, you know, and then during my walk, you know, the closer I got to God, the more I read and prayed and kind of just embraced this new lifestyle, I started being able to write. And my songs changed, you know? And now I realize there's a lot of amazing Christian artists out there. It's just like anything, you know, there's, you know, in regular rap, there's great rappers and then there's horrible rappers. And same in Christian music, you know, there's great artists and then there's not ones that aren't that great. But then I started being able to write, and I started writing songs, you know. And when I first did it, I wasn't even sure if they're Christian songs because my nature is a little bit aggressive, you know. And so I had written all these songs, which ended up then being on an album called Revelation, which is out if anybody wants to hear it. And if you Google it, I have it on iTunes, so you can buy it if you want to support what I do. If not, I have it out there for free. So if you Google it, I'm sure you'll find the downloads and whatnot. But when I was writing that album, because some of the songs were real buck, you know, I didn't even know, is this Christian music, is it not? You know, I didn't even know what that means, you know? And, bro, true story, I was at church one Sunday morning, some African dude walks up to me. I'd never seen him before or since. He walks up to me, and he's like, hey, God gave me a word for you. Can I tell you? And, you know, when people tell me stuff like that, I'm always suspect of it. Because I'm like, I don't know, you might tell me something weird or something crazy or whatever.
Right.
But I was like, go ahead, bro. You know, I'm like, go ahead, what you got to say? And he's like, God told me he picked you because you're aggressive. So don't doubt it and just finish the music you're working on.
Oh,
and bro,
snap.
Like, I almost, yeah, like, I got teared up, you know, because I was like, all right, I'm going to just trust this. So that's the trajectory my life took, you know. So now that's the style of music I do. We got a couple albums, bunch of singles that are being released this year. You know, the latest, it's called Rebel Music. You guys can download it free and see the mission and the purpose of what I'm doing now.
And actually, I was going to ask you, yeah. Marz, about Christian rap specifically. Have you heard of the rapper Killa C?
Yes, and I know Killa C. Like, we were on tour a couple times, and I remember speaking to him. We never spoke about, you know, Christianity, but I've heard that he got saved, too. Is that true?
He did, yeah, and his new album is all... It's a Christian now. I haven't listened to the whole thing, but I've listened to a few songs off it, and it's actually really dope. But
yeah, you know, God bless him, and if anybody knows him, tell him I said what up. I send him blessings, man. I hope he does what he was meant to do, like all of us.
You had that awakening. That was on the tour with Tech and Paul Wall. Was that... Correct me if I'm wrong on this, because I'm not sure if this is right information, but did you have a hit out on your life?
I definitely had a situation where... Yeah, it's a crazy story, bro. I had gotten involved in some things. First off, kind of to touch on the thing with ICP, you know, I got a lot of hate for my beef with ICP, and most of it I probably deserved. You know what I'm saying? Some of, maybe not all of it, but most of it I did because I was in my own zone. And if we're living, you got to realize we're all exactly the same. Like, all of us have the same issues. You know what I mean? Mine might have been bigger, but we all have the same issues of pride and lust and arrogance. And at that time, it was actually after me and ICP already kind of split. I was living out in L.A., and I got into a situation that was my fault. Like, well, I was completely to blame for the problem that I was experiencing. And the thing is, the person that tried to kind of get rid of me try to do it through someone that was actually a friend of mine.
Oh, that doesn't
follow
work.
That?
Yep.
Now, but look at, even before, now looking back, I could see how God protected me in so many places. I mean, what are the chances, bro? What are the chances of someone wanting to put a hit out on you, and the person that they go to get to do it happens to be a super tight friend of yours?
Right, yeah, it's your
You know
movie.
What I'm saying? Like, yeah, and actually, and that guy, the dude, he's a shooter, bro. The guy that got asked to, he didn't get asked, but the guy that, you know, got hired to get rid of me, he's also saved now. So now when we talk, and we're still friends, you know, and it's crazy, bro. Like, the things that he used to do for money, like, this guy is no joke. He's the type of dude, like, if anybody has a problem, he takes care of it. He'll go and kidnap somebody, hold him hostage for days or weeks, and beat them until he gets that money. You know what I mean? Like, he's
wow.
not a joke.
Right.
It's not a thing of, like, of pretend or something like that. Like, it was serious. But he also, and he's been shot a bunch of times, man. But he also came to Christ. So it's crazy. So now, I mean, before our talks would be gangster talks. Like, we would talk about whatever, you know, war stories and things like trying to show each other how tough we are or what the things we went through. And now our conversations are totally different. It's crazy how life works. You know what I mean? Now our conversations is like, my mission right now with this album and with the rest of the music I'm doing is, if you listen to it, or Juggalos, or whoever would listen to it, that you leave from it when you turn it off, that you're bigger and you're more blessed than you were before you listened to it. That it would strengthen you, empower you, encourage you, get you through whatever situation you're going through, and connect you back with your maker. You dig? And in a serious way, not in like some corny way or some religious way, but in a for real way, in a tangible way, that when you play that music and if you say those lyrics, that it's going to be a blessing to your life. That's my goal. My
right.
goal before used to be famous, to get money, to have power, to get women. Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
the,
yeah.
The purpose and the goal has completely shifted.
Well, I noticed in past lyrics, they almost seemed like almost anti-theistic, some of the lyrics that you would spit. Do you regret spitting those lyrics now, or was it all just part of the plan?
I regret it at first. It was almost like we all have this veil over our eyes, right? I believe that veil is only removed in Christ, in Jesus. When the veil was removed from my eyes, when I first saw all the things that I did, whether it was lyrics or the things that I was involved with in my life, you know, it was embarrassing, you
right.
know, because I saw it different. I'm not embarrassed about it now because I understand it was all those things and going through those things that brought me to where I am. And now I look at it as it shows the power of God. If God could do what he did with me, he could do it with anybody. Do you know what I'm saying? So now I look at it, whether it was the lyrics or whatever I was, and I look at it as it's glory to God. It shows the power of God to be able to take someone's life and to turn it around, you know? I don't regret it. I'm not embarrassed by it anymore. Now I look at it like, yeah, that's where I came from. This is where I'm at now. You know what I mean? And it helps me be able to speak. So, for example, like, I could speak to gangbangers. I could speak to killers. I could speak to murderers. I could speak to juggalos. Because I've been in those situations and around those people. And when you've been there, I can speak to it. Now, had it been the other way around, let's say that I had never been involved in those situations, I could never speak to those people that are in those situations trying to get out.
Right,
you
right.
Because I would have no authority. Like, how are you going to talk to me when you ain't never been in this situation? Do you know what I'm saying? How are you going to tell me not to gangbang when you ain't never been around gangbang? You follow me? So I trust that it was all God's plan. You know, even like some of the lyrics that I said it, you know, in the Dark Lotus album, that I went hard. That's where I was at the time. And looking back, you know, looking back, I think a lot of the times Christians, we get it wrong. I remember one time, bro, I came out of the house and this pastor, way before I got saved, this pastor walks up to me, he has a Bible in his hand with a little kid. And he's like, can I talk to you for a minute and tell you about eternal life? And I'm like, yeah, man, what's up? He's like, did you know you're going to burn in hell in conscious torment for eternity? unless you believe in Jesus, right? And I was like, no, I didn't know that. Can you show me that in the Bible? Bro, he opens up the Bible, and whatever it had said there before, I don't remember what scripture he read me, but above it, he wrote in red pen, burn in hell in conscious torment forever.
So it was in his Bible.
So I thought, yeah, like he wrote that in.
Right.
So I was like, you know, I thought he was playing with me. So I'm like, my man, that's not what that says. Like, you, what did it say there before? Because you wrote that in, right? He's like, well, that's what it means. And I'm like, come on, man. Like, you wrote that. He snaps his Bible shut, and he's like, good luck burning, gentlemen, because I was with one of my dudes. And I was like, dang, if that's what Christianity is, I don't want it.
Now, you said it was a pastor?
I mean? Yeah, like, it was a pastor. Like, he was evangelizing, but he was doing a horrible job.
It sounds
like
it.
Dude, yeah, you know, so I had a lot of rebellion in me against that. So some of the lyrics, especially on the ICP album, came from that. Because some people get it wrong. I get it wrong. We all get it wrong. You know what I'm saying? No matter what it is, whether it's, you know, whether it's spirituality, whatever. There's times that we're wrong. You know what I'm saying?
Right, like, right.
We just got it twisted. So, you know.
Hey, Marz, we're going to get on back on the subject of music.
All right. We probably lost a lot of people, but let's come back.
All right. What was your opinion of ICP's message that was put forth on the sixth Joker's card?
Where he said, Marz, you never wore Lotus, and you noticed that?
No, the, like on ICP's sixth Joker's card, the Wraith, on the last song, they revealed that the carnival is God, and may all Juggalos find him. What was your opinion on them releasing that message?
I don't know. I don't know if I really have an opinion, because I, you know, I haven't spoke to them in so long, bro, so I don't know where his heart is. I don't know if he meant that. I don't know what God is doing in his life, you know? So I don't want to belittle it if he's genuine, you know?
Right.
At the same time, I feel like the only truth in this life is Jesus. So if we're genuinely searching, all roads lead to him. So I trust and I have faith that if Jay and Shaggy and whoever else, whatever Juggalos might have been influenced by that, if they're genuinely searching for God, God will reveal himself, you know? So I tell you, you know, my hope is that he was genuine, and my hope is that that's where he is being led, you know? And so maybe I'll leave it at that, you know? I would love to talk to him. I would love to see where he's at, you know? I'm sure we're both different people than we were at the time when we got, when we were beefing for whatever reason, you know. I'm sure we've both grown and matured, and so I will be open to talking to him. I will be open to speaking life to him and blessing him, you know, and seeing where he's at. But as far as, like, what did he mean by it, was it true or not, I don't know, but I hope it was.
So I did listen to that new Rebel Music mixtape. Congrats on that, man, because it was awesome.
Thank you, bro.
Not as explicit as some of the music I listen to. I figured it was a little bit safer.
Yeah, there's no cussing, man. Like, I don't cuss. I don't degrade women, you know, and there's none of that. And you know what's weird, though? Like, a couple of the songs, I've had people hit me back up and be like, man, I listened to this, and the whole time I thought you were just cussing and, you know what I mean, saying all these things. And he's like, then I started paying attention, and I was like, wow, he's not doing any of that.
Yeah,
you know? So different people listen to music for different reasons. Some people let the beat just bang out. Some people listen to the flow, and then some people pay attention to the lyrics.
Well, even on that album, man, like the beat and the flow, it almost seems like it could be one of those type of songs where you are talking about, you know, gangbanging and everything else, but the message coming across is totally different than what you would expect in that type of music.
Yeah, and you know, and that's kind of my goal. My goal is, because hip-hop is a language, you know, and bro, and I got to tour the world, and I got to see it, man, like kids listening to hip-hop and all over the world, in Hungary and Italy and in Sweden, and you know, and now it's a worldwide thing, and it's a language, you know, and certain people relate more to a certain language. And so to me, what hip-hop is now is a means for me to share a message. You know, the message is no longer how cool I am and how, you know what I'm saying, how raw I am, you know what I mean, it's all about me. That's not the message. The message is something completely different, and I'm just using the media or the platform of hip-hop to spread that message.
Any chance of re-releasing any of your old albums, your old discography?
Probably not. I mean, I took it off. I think I took Lil Fumo She off, too.
Yeah, it's not
the
up
only
there,
thing
no.
that's. Yeah, I took it all down, bro, and I struggled with that for a couple years. You know, like because it was up and I was still making money off of it, but I felt like it was poison. You know, and I'm like, dang, what do I do? And then one day, like, I just decided I'm gonna just take it down. You know, and bro, that you want to talk about a humbling experience? What I worked on for, you know, 15, 20 years of my life, just gone.
Right, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's something that I put so much time into every day. I wasn't like a part-time rapper type of thing, you know what I mean? I worked on music every day, you know, and I produced music, and I tried to write songs that were different and powerful, and, you know, and then all of a sudden, I take it all away. You know, I took it all down, man. That was something, bro.
Wow, you know? I couldn't even imagine, man. Did you consider yourself a Juggalo, or do you still consider yourself a Juggalo?
I'm ready. I didn't even know what Juggalos were, bro. When I got on a tour with ICP, it was because the label that I was on, they were looking for a tour for me. They called me up. I didn't even know who ICP was, man. They're like, there's a group called the Insane Clown Posse. I just asked, is it rap? And there was a hip-hop. And they're like, yeah, they're a rap. They're a rap crew. And I'm like, all right, cool. So then I looked them up. I'm like, oh, okay. This looks interesting. So the first time I'd ever even heard a Juggalo song or ICP was at the first show that right. we did. You know, so I had no idea about that culture. I had nothing to do with it. I came from a different culture, bro. I came from a Chicago gang culture. So it was a little bit different. You know what I mean? And so, you know, when it first started, I was very heavily embraced by Juggalos. Like,
of course.
And that was a problem. And that was one of the issues with Jay and me.
Juggalos loved you.
He eventually called me. Yeah. And I wasn't signed to his label, you know? And he knew I was already signed. When he asked me to do Dark Lotus, he knew I was already signed to another label. And the label I was on actually was cool enough to let me do it.
Right.
You know what I mean? But then what happened is, then when Dark Lotus was released, he said every time he went on the internet, anytime he, you know, spoke about Juggalos, anytime he did interviews, all the questions were about me. And he's like, you're not even on our label, man. Like, this can't happen. You know what I mean? And I'm like, well, what do you want me to do? You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know. You asked me to be on this, you know? And so that's where the tension between me and him had started, you know? So I didn't even know about Juggalos, bro. I know that I got love for Juggalos. I will bless them. You know, I know a lot of them hated me and they didn't even know why. It's just one of those things where because I was beefing with Jay, they stayed loyal and it's cool. I ain't even mad at the ones that did that. I know a lot of Juggalos did not do that. When I would still do shows or when I would see Juggalos at tech shows, I got crazy love, bro. They showed me crazy amounts of love, you know, and I appreciate that. And that's one of the reasons that I really am open to doing this interview or doing whatever in the Juggalo culture because I pray my music blesses them. You dig what I'm saying? I'm not doing this so then Juggalos will think I'm a great rapper. I'm doing this in the hopes that Juggalos listen to whether it's the mixtape or the albums we got coming out and that it blesses their life. And you could even still hate me. I don't care as long as it blesses your life. Do you know what I mean?
One final question before we take off here, Marz. If you were stranded on an island with a Discman and you only had 3 CDs with you, what 3 CDs do you got?
Oh, man, 3 CDs. I would probably say there's a rapper in Chicago named Gemstones. He's a monster, bro. He's a rapper, singer. I would definitely have to have some Gemstones. Then I would have some like rock music, which is there's a Christian band called Hillsong from Australia that... completely opposite of what I do and the type of music I write, but I really love listening to them. And then the third one, I'll probably have one of my own CDs. I ain't even lying because I've been listening to my music a lot.
You know what? I've been waiting for somebody to say that.
Only, I know, and it's funny, man, because it's kind of, my wife kind of makes fun of me about that because I do, you know what I'm saying? Thank God that I do enjoy listening to it because it would kind of be horrible if I hated my own music, you know? But I use those 3 albums I would use for different things. I would use my music when I needed to get hyped up and strengthened to go into war type of thing. I would listen to the Hillsong when it's like relaxing time and just chilling out and just like a super cool chill vibe. And I would listen to Gemstones when it's like introspective songs, you know, to think deep thoughts, so to say, you know?
All right, homie. So, Any final words that you have for the Juggalos, for all the people listening before we take off here?
Yeah, man. You guys are loved. God loves you. He's calling you back. He's going to chase you, and you will never get away from him. And he will finish the work he started in you guys. So God bless you guys. I look forward to seeing some of y'all, you know, again, whether it's at shows or whether we talk on the internet or wherever. But that's my message. You are loved more than you ever imagined. In Jesus' name.
Thank you so much, Marz.
Yes, sir.
Juggalos, rejoice! The 17 is here, yo!
And it's got me motherfucking screaming all up in that ear hole.
Some call this shit the secret.
Some say laws of attraction.
The powers of a positive mind are bitch-slapping. Ninjas, just know that we love you.
And all we speak is true.
You can have anything you want, and all you gotta do is know that shit would happen, like we did with rapping. That's the secret we're sharing. Juggalos, maybe you should
use that shit on you and know that it's true.
Even scrubs like us can have anything they want to. Have faith in yourself, ninja.
The year is 17.
It's our time to shine up in heaven's beam.
Thanks for hearing us out. But if we bored you,
all that bitching you did, we ignored you.
If just one Juggalo sees this
right when they need it,
bitch, the Hatchet Fam's mission's completed.
That's going to do it for this episode of the Faygoluvers Podcast. I want to thank all you ninjas for tuning in. Want to give a big shout out to our homie Marz. Thank you so much for coming on and talking to us, homie, and the exclusive interview that we did with Marz. So this was part of the exclusive, but the exclusive interview is actually much longer than the interview that you just heard with Marz. That's going to be dropping in the next 2 days. Definitely stay tuned to Faygoluvers.net to hear that. His album, Rebel Music, is available for free download. Check out the link in the description of this podcast. And although we're not like a Christian rap site, and I'm not a huge fan of Christian rap, it's definitely a banger. Definitely check that shit out because I enjoyed it. Want to give a big shout out to Nikki Wickked, the newest ninjette to Faygoluvers, and the newest news ninjette to Faygoluvers.net. Thank you so much for coming on and talking to me on the podcast. On the next episode, we're going to have our homie, Des Luca. And I actually have to apologize because the interview that we did with Des Luca was done a long time ago, long before the Fresh Kid Ice interview or this Marz interview. His episode is coming out 2 weeks from now on Sunday. Definitely check that shit out. 5 or 4 star reviews. We have a 5-star review on iTunes from a ninja named Juggalo Jarvis. Check it out. He had to say, big fan of the podcast. Roscoe kills it with dope interviews and the newest and freshest news of the underground. This is a must subscribe. Hells yeah. Much love to you, Juggalo Jarvis. Thank you so much for that review. 5 stars. Hell yeah. Ninjas, if you want me to read your comment on the air, just hit up iTunes, the Faygoluvers Podcast on iTunes. Give us a 4 or 5 star review and I will read that shit on the podcast. That's it, homie. So until next time, this is your homie Roscoe reminding you to keep an open mind. Peace.
One time for my brothers, that's a lock up. 2 times for them baby mamas on the block. 3 times for them shorties when they pop up. 4 times for my homies trying to get a job. 5 times for them lying politician tricks. 6 times for that custody trying to get a hint. 7 times for that spirit that's from heaven. Fearless, cause that love lives forever. Face fair with a right cross uppercut. Stay swinging out the gate today in the dust. Faithful to that grace that was given blood. Heart bold in the storm when you live for love. The streets lie cause they evil. 4-5 flash by till they reload. Wrong place, wrong time, by amigo. Body here, but he not, where did he go? Hypnotized by the shine of them diamonds. Open your eyes, look at you surrounded by liars. They liars, you know liars, they lying. Wake up and shake it off, throw you food for them tyrants. It's a war for your mind, know the enemy, the choppers is popping for profits.
so readily.
You now
finna stop me from popping the remedy. I'm priceless, the son of a king. Check the pedigree.
One time for my brothers, that's a lock up. Two times for them baby mamas on the block. Three times for them shorties when they pop up. Four times for my homies trying to get a job. Five times for them lying politician tricks. Six times for that custody trying to get a hit. Seven times for that spirit that's from heaven. Fearless, cause that love lives forever. A fool say in his heart there is no God. Oh my God, you was dumb, there was so God. All these frauds trying to front like they so hard. Keep it real, we all lost like a hurt child. Some pain too deep for a real tear. So we tatted on our face right there. Gunpowder everywhere in the night air. Never scared cause my papa right here. I see a vision in 3D high definition. We painting a precious picture and pushing a perfect mission. You ain't with it, you gon' get it. We mashing the competition. Is you with it, then let's get it. We winning, it ain't no question. A lost world finna be free. I decree I can see the enemy clearly. Squad up, we finna ride on a murderer. Prayers chop his head off. Is you ready, bruh? One time for my brothers, that's a lock up. Two times for them baby mamas on the block. Three times for them shorties when they pop up. Four times for my homies trying to get a job. Five times for them lying politician tricks. Six times for that custody trying to get a hint. Seven times for that spirit that's from heaven. Fearless, cause that love lives forever.
We in the eye of a hurricane. Marinating on the top of a pyramid. Navigating through the hate and the Nephilim. I know who the gate is, so I let them in. Heartbeat like a war drum. Boots ready to get started for the kingdom. Man, I've been ready, been done. And them giants is our food, eat son. I've been a warrior before this world was in order. Before the earth was in orbit. My proclamation's enormous, my focus staying on focus. My hope is filling the hopeless and showing them how ferocious the love of the truest love is. Shake it off, push it off through the math, jump. We eternal, the purpose is not dope. Let it burn, if it's true, it will not go.
I know you said you thought that it's kind of like Poison now, but that OG Tales of the Lotus Pod was literally like the third album I ever actually listened to. So your rapping on that album, like you as a rapper, was one of the people who actually got me motivated and interested in rap. And that was, what, 16 years ago now. So for me to be talking to you right now, man, is so dope for me. It might not sound like I'm that excited about it, but it's super duper dope for me. So I really, really appreciate this, man.
Thank you, bro. I appreciate it. You know, and maybe to like clarify what I meant by poison is when I'm rapping stuff about chasing money or getting hoes or, you know what I mean? Like kind of chasing these things that are fleeting and they just disappear. That's what I mean by poison.
Right. You know, I got you though.
Or, you know, writing rap songs. You did what I'm saying, like, so that's what I meant, you know, not saying that there wasn't positive stuff because there was other songs that I wrote and there was positivity. But it was few and far between.